want to give you my testimony. I'm here to tell you, I'm not just in the church, but the church is in me. When I was a much younger man, and my mother and my father made me go to church, and I said, when I get grown, I'll decide whether I go to church or not. And when they made me stay all day long, I kept saying, I'll be glad when I get grown. When I left home, 700 miles from my mother and father, they were not there to make me go to church. But every Sunday morning, something on the inside said, you can't stay home today. You need to go and worship the Lord. And I found myself going when I said I wouldn't go. Some of y'all know what I'm talking about. But I found out something. When nobody has to make you go, your religion can be more real to you. Can I get a witness? And I don't know about you, but I'm in the church today, and the church is in me. They criticize on the radio and television big churches, but I'm glad to be the part of a big church. Because if your church been a church 50 years and you still don't have but 10 members, something is wrong somewhere. But when the word is going forward, somebody want to be a part of what you are. Can I get a witness here? We got liars in the church. We got backbiters in the church. We got peacebreakers in the church. But that's only on one side. But on the other side, we got Jesus. He's in the church, y'all. And when Jesus is in the church, he's worth more than all of the hypocrites in the world. In the church, we got love. In the church, we got peace. In the church, we got joy, long-suffering, gentleness, kindness, meekness. It's all in the church. And I tell you what, you decide which side you're going to be on. Will you be a member or will you be in the church? When you're a member, you might feel something, but you might not. But when you're in the church, whenever the word goes forward, something on the inside starts moving. Something on the inside starts turning in you. Sometimes when you realize you're already standing up, praising the Lord, all I want to ask today is, there anybody in here who are in the church Or is there anybody in here and the church is in you? Is there anybody who's afraid to praise the Lord? Or is there somebody here who doesn't mind the world knowing what side you're on? Now, I want all the church members to just be quiet like you've been. But if you know, you know, the church is in you. And you are not in control of your religion. I want to give God some crazy praise. I'm going to count to three, and I want it to seem like we are out at Atlanta Stadium. I want it to seem like Andrew Jones just hit a home run. One, two, three. The reason you shouldn't be ashamed, if your favorite rap artist came in here today, if your favorite rock artist came by today, we would stand and give them a standing ovation. If you were in the stadium and the Braves just won the World Series, you wouldn't be ashamed to praise the Lord. But I know somebody who's done more for you than a rap artist could ever do. I know somebody who had done more for you than the Braves will ever do. You see, when the Braves get their checks, they don't even know your name. But I know somebody that when praises go up, blessings will come on down. If you want a blessing, you ought to praise him right now. Yay! Yay! Yes! Do you know him? Is he all right? Has he ever done anything for you? Has the Lord been your friend? Say yeah! Yeah! Hey! And when you let him, he'll live in you. And he'll take care of you.